All right, now everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm going to show you how to add subtitles in different languages today. It's a little bit different video, but a little education. If you got a YouTube channel, this will certainly help, and somebody out there might be searching to this. So go ahead, subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to watch more videos if you do subscribe. So let's jump right into this. Here's just one of my random videos I have pulled up here now, and when you click on settings, you can see that you can select the subtitles, and I have seven different subtitles. And all of these, Chinese, English, Greek, Norwegian, Russian, Thai, English. Now, you're going to have to add anything other than English, you have to add manually. This Chinese and Greek and Norwegian, that's not in there. You have to do that manually, and it's a little bit of a process. And also, I wanted to show you about this audio track here. This is called audio dubbing, and I did a post on this. If you go to my channel and click on posts, you can read about the audio dubbing that is in the pipeline for YouTube. They're going to be adding more languages. There's about 12 new languages they're going to be adding. I think it's 10 more, actually. But the auto dubbing or audio dubbing, it puts in a synthetic AI-generated computer voice or whatever and automatically translates your voice into an audio track like you're listening to a book or something in different languages, okay? So they have all of these languages: Dutch, French, German, Hindi, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Polish, Portuguese, and Spanish. So that's your audio dubbing, okay? So that's different than the subtitles. Now, to turn on your audio dubbing, I just wanted to show you this real quick. It's a little bit difficult to find, but go into your studio and click on settings down here, and then you want to go to your upload defaults, and then when you come down here you'll see automatic dubbing, and you want to click on this allow automatic dubbing. Now, YouTube should take that upon themselves to start automatically dubbing that. I mean, so it may take 24 to 48 hours for them to process it and for the system to update. But then again, you're also kind of at the mercy of YouTube. I have seen some of my videos where it just decides not to do it. If there's a lot of music in your videos, it won't do it. Say predominantly, I have some videos where maybe you'll just show yourself doing something for 10 minutes and put it on a time lapse and play music. And then at the very end of the video, maybe just give a sign off and say thanks for watching or something. It will not audio dub those or auto dub those. Because it's all music and it has to space it out into, it just doesn't work. If it's all music playing for 10 minutes, it doesn't work. It puts in brackets, music, 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 and it would do that the whole time, and it's just weird looking. So it doesn't do that. So that's your audio dubbing. You want to turn that on in your settings, upload defaults, advanced settings. You can get to that, okay? Now, moving on. If you want to add an audio, or excuse me, if you want to add the different languages in your subtitles, so other people like in China or Russia, some of these other markets, Thai, Greek, can read along in the subtitles and still be able to read your videos, I'll show you how to do that. So we'll just choose this video here. It's coming up. And you're going to want to click on that. Click on whatever video you want to do. And then you're going to want to come to this languages tab over here on the left. If you see where my mouse is, you're going to want to get familiar with using that languages tab. All of these settings are going to be in the languages. So come over here to languages on that video and click on it. And you can see these are all of my audio dubbed tracks, the same options. These are all of the voice audio that it automatically does, and it gives you a computer generated voice. And how I stumbled onto this was, it says right here at the top, right here, there's a red exclamation point and it says, review your dubbed voice. This feature is new and may not represent your voice. So I thought, oh, cool. Well, I can pick a AI voice, whatever voice I want to sound like me, and choose what voice I want to use. Well, I was never able to find that. It gives you a voice and that's it. So I think, I'm not sure what it's saying. I guess it's just saying review it if you want to, and you can maybe come in here and delete some of these. You can delete them. If you click on this, you can delete them. So I guess if you're not happy with it, you could delete it. I guess that's all that's saying, because I was not able to figure out how to change the actual voice that it uses. So if anybody knows how to do that, put it in the comments, because that's how I kind of stumbled onto all this. I started playing with all these settings. Okay, now, so back into your subtitles. In order to publish subtitles in different languages, this is really important. The first thing you have to do is upload the subtitles, period. So if you wanted to write them out by hand, see, here's your, you could do it manually, right here, manually. Here's your video, it's in English. So English subtitles are the default source for auto-translated subtitles. So you first have to have English subtitles uploaded. You can do that manually. If you want to sit there and upload and write frame by frame and space it all out and do it by hand for the entire video, you can. I am not going to do that in this video. You can learn how to do that. That takes way too much time. If you just click on this right here, edit subtitles, it automatically generates all of this work for you already. There's all of your subtitles done, and it's AI or computer generated, whatever you want to say. So there could be mistakes in this. I don't even read them. I started going through and trying to do a bunch of my old videos, and I don't have time to sit there and read through this whole script of all of the text. So I just go with it. I figure it's close enough. If it misses a word here or there, other people will still be able to get a pretty good idea of what you're saying. And now these are pretty good, but some words it may trip over and say the wrong thing. Just like using autocorrect on your phone. Sometimes you're trying to write one word, it changes it to something a little different. Stuff like that can happen. So if you want them to be perfect, read through this whole script and look for words that are not the right word or whatever. And it does put music in parentheses. Like right here, it says music. It does a pretty good job about spacing everything out and all of that. So the music will all be in there. It'll all be spaced out. It'll be very good. So one thing I want to mention is when you click on this, if you're doing a lot of videos, don't move too fast. I started getting into the flow and I was just clicking on edit, then I was clicking on publish, then I was clicking on the next step, then the next step, then the next. Give it a few seconds just to load everything. You'll see here along the bottom these little gray lines. If you follow my mouse, like right here at the top, you'll see the gray lines appear all across, and that is where your subtitles are. So I have music and an introduction, and then I start talking right here. Well, all right now. So you'll see these gray lines pop up and load along the bottom. Generally, once the gray lines go all the way across, it's good to go. But if you sit there and just go publish, go, and you try to get into a really fast flow, it doesn't work. It doesn't give it time to complete the whole video and auto-translate it and then load them and space them out to where they need to be down here on the track and everything, and it will fail. So give it just a second. Don't rush it too much. I'm sure you know what I'm saying there. So that is all of your subtitles. They're already automatically generated. Okay, so you're done there. Just hit publish. And now you have published your English subtitles. Like I said, you could do that manually and do all of that work by hand. I don't know who wants to do that, but if you want to be really professional, you can. So you have now published your English subtitles and you have a base text for the program to work on. That's real important. You have to do that first. You can't just come in and hit add language because it doesn't have anything to work from. So now that we've done that, you can come over here and hit add language. So you can now choose from any of these languages pretty much. I haven't found any that you haven't been able to do. But so say you want to do Greek. I usually just type G. I don't know. Hold on, let me get out of here. How'd I do that? Add language. And then, yeah, I usually just hit G and then it'll bring you to the G's. And then right down here, say you want to do Greek. Hit Greek. Now, this title and description, I don't even put anything in there. You can figure that out if you want to. But I don't know if you're, let's see, test. Yeah, you'd have to write that in Greek, I guess. I don't know if it auto-translates your titles or not. It doesn't sound like it. So anyways, once you click that, come down here to manual subtitles and hit add. Okay, so now again, you have all of these options and you can upload a file, you can type them manually, or you can auto-translate. But here's the thing, if you, like, that's the thing I was saying with the descriptions. Greek letters, the Greek alphabet is not the same as the English alphabet, or Russian, or Chinese, or Japanese, so you'd have a pretty hard time, I would assume, trying to type these Greek subtitles manually, unless you have a Chinese keyboard, all right? So again, I let the computer do it. You come down here to auto translate, and all you have to do is click on auto translate and watch these bottom. See that little line up here? Give that just a second to load. And now here you can see that it's already all the same phrases that are down here. This was when I said, all right, well, welcome to the channel. Whatever I said here, here it is down here in Greek. And this is obviously music in Greek, whatever that word is. So it's already done. It has all the stuff about my capsoxyla and all that already loaded there. And that's basically it. You're done with that. It's got everything phrased out and you just hit publish. So now when you look at your list down here, you have your Greek and it says one published and that's your subtitle. You can see it's under the subtitle heading right here, subtitles. This Greek has subtitles. It's not audio, it's subtitles. So that will now be in the drop-down list on your videos and you can select Greek. So let's do another one. You would hit add language and say you want to add Chinese. You come down here to the C's. Click Chinese. Now there's all these different Chinese, China, Hong Kong, simplified, Singapore, whatever. I just picked Chinese. Gives more people, I'm sure those languages are all pretty similar. And you just add, come down here to auto translate. And you can see, all right, see that line pop up down here? It's done. That's not a great example because I have all this music, but normally this gray line goes all the way across if you start talking right away. So there's your Chinese that all comes in there and it's all loaded and phrased out and everything. Give it a second to load and you hit publish. All right, so you're done there. We'll do one more. Say you want to add, I don't know, Thai, Taiwanese, add Thai. Come down here to add manual subtitles, auto translate. And there it goes. There it popped up and loaded. And there's your tie. So that's what I'm saying. You would have to be able to type in that language to add the descriptions on the previous page. So I just don't add prescriptions, descriptions, or titles in these new languages. I just leave that blank and I don't worry about it. You might want to do that though, because then it may be more searchable. I don't know. That could be important. So that's worth thinking about if you wanted to have, let's just do another one. Japanese, it's already auto. What's another one here? We'll do Russian. So these titles and descriptions, they might actually be important because that could enable them to search in Russian to find your videos better. So that's worth considering. You might want to do that. So we'll add Russian real quick while I'm in here. Auto-translate. There it loaded. Boom. So in order to do that, if you wanted to add a title and description, you're going to have to go to like Google Translate on Google.com, write a description and a title, and then copy it with your mouse. Just copy and paste it, and then paste that title in a different language into your title and your description. I have not been doing that, but the more I think about it, I probably should. So there you go. Now all your subtitles will be there when you click on your videos. It'll all be loaded right here. So you'll click on your settings and it'll be just like at the beginning of the video. You'll have all your new subtitles. And when you watch your video, there it is. So it's loaded in Greek right here. And it'll go through the whole video. So people in other countries, it opens up your videos to a whole new market. And like I said, the titles and descriptions might make it more searchable for those people in other countries. That might be important, and I'm missing that on my own videos, but I told you how to do it. I might start doing that myself. All right, everybody, I decided to go ahead and start adding some of these titles. I'm going to show y'all how to do that just using Google Translate. You could use Translate on your iPhone or a lot of things. There's a translation app on iPhones. So we're at Google Translate, and I'm going English to Russian. So I'm just going to call this video, say, Delivering Firewood in Kentucky. Delivering Firewood in Kentucky. So there's your Russian text of that title, Delivering Firewood in Kentucky. Just copy that. And then come back over here. We're already in Russian, so your title is going to be that. And you could write a description if you wanted to. I delivered a bunch of wood. I don't know, just for your description there. And you put that in your description. There's your description in Russian. So you want to update your file, or you could have done that from the beginning. And there you go. So that's all you have to do if you want to write your title in a different language. May help it be more searchable. Hope that helps you out. So just a little tidbit there. I'm going to wrap this up now. Thanks for watching. Hope you learned something. Hope this helps your YouTube channel. And I'll see you guys next time.